Hello there, crafty friends. It's Alicia of the Call Me Crafty Owl YouTube channel, and I'm so glad that you could join me today. It is the 15th of the month, which means it is time for another round of the Oh So Inspired collaboration here on YouTube. This is a collaboration that I host each month here on YouTube, and what we do is take one piece that we have found maybe on YouTube, on Pinterest, on a blog, and we create something that is inspired by that creation. The fun part about this collaboration is that you're probably gonna see something completely different at each of the channels that you visit. Don't forget, starting last month, I shared a video how you can play along with us and perhaps be invited to be on the team for the July through December term. If you wanna know more about that, I have the video linked in the description box below. And if you are going to play along this month with us, you will need to put in your description box the hashtag IWasOSIFeb2019. I'm going to pop that up on the screen now so you can look at it. Make sure the hashtag looks exactly like that. That is the only way that I can search and find your video if you have played along. There can't be any spaces, you can't add things at the end, do not spell out February, and so forth. But anyway, I hope that you will play along, show us your creations, even if you don't kind of want to try out for a spot on the team. I always love to see how the piece inspires our viewers as well. For this month's inspiration, we used an altered tag that was created by Tracy Evans. The pin and her blog posts are both linked below, but I'll go ahead here and show you a quick picture of the piece. So what I liked from that piece was kind of the slanted pockets and how things were tucked inside those on the tag. So today's video is only going to be a project share. I'll kind of tell you quickly how I made it, but I won't be doing a process. If you would like to see a process video, let me know in the description box below. And if enough of you want that, then I will go ahead and come back with another video. But for today, it will just be quick. So in front of me here are some of the supplies that I have used besides, you know, your standard adhesive and trimmers. For my stamp sentiment, I used the Fresh Ink Pigment Stamp Pad in Slate, and I used the My Favorite Things gift card greeting set. I used the one that says, "Thanks for doing that thing you did," because I wanted to turn mine into kind of like a thank you and a little gift card holder. For my die cut sentiment, I used this thanks die from Stamp Anything. I did create a tag on my card, so I used the We Are Memory Keepers hole reinforcer punch. And then for the papers, I pulled out one of my very favorites. This is the Die Cuts with the View Happy Day Stack. I picked this up at Joann's a few years ago, and I use it sparingly because I love it so much. Like I mentioned before, I was inspired by the tag shape and how they had the pockets with things tucked inside. And so I created a little thank you card gift card holder. I put it in a vellum envelope. I always like the way that you can kind of see a little bit of what's inside. So here is a look at it. I used 4 scraps of the paper from the paper pad. You can see here in the bottom pocket, I have inserted a little Michaels gift card. I love how the chalkboard effect goes with the papers. At the bottom, I have die cut thanks. I die cut it in the pink with gold dots pattern paper, and then I also die cut it with white cardstock, and I thought offsetting those just helped the thanks stand out from the pattern paper since the wood grain with the floral is a little bold. Now in the top here, I have created a tag shaped card. The front side that you see when you get the card, it has gold metallic stripes on it. And then on the back side is where I stamped my thanks for doing that thing you did sentiment. And then I could write my personal message to the recipient here. This is just a flat card basically with those pockets. It doesn't open up. The back is just white. I thought it was pretty fun, a cute way to give a little thank you and a little gift with it. This would be good, you know, if you wanted to give like maybe a teacher a little gift card or a coworker or a friend. Again, let me know below if you would like me to show you how I made this and I can do a tutorial video. If you are going to play along, don't forget that you will want to use the hashtag IWasOSIFeb2019. And don't forget to visit all of the other collaborators. Each of their channels is linked in the description box below. I know that you are going to enjoy going, stopping by each of them and seeing how they were inspired. And while you're there, thumbs up and maybe a little love in the comments is always appreciated. Until my next video, and as always, I hope you're having a crafty day. Bye-bye.